My name is Geoff Brock.
Hi.
And I'm reading for the 32 Hawks team. This is a poem called Bryant Park at Dusk. Bryant Park is a park in Manhattan right next to the New York Public Library. Floodlights have flared on behind and above where I sit in my public chair. The lawn that had gradually darkened has brightened. The library windows stare. I'm alone in a crowd, e pluribus pluris, far from a family I miss. I'd almost say I'm lonely, but lonely is worse, I recall, than this. Loneliness is a genuine poverty. I'm like a man who was flush but forgot his wallet on the nightstand when he left for work in a rush and now must go without food and coffee for a few hours more than he'd wish. That's all. He still has a wallet. It's bulging. It floats through his brain like a fish. Money for love? A terrible simile. But maybe it's fitting here, a couple of blocks from Madison Avenue where commodities are dear. For all around me, rich skyscrapers woo the impoverished sky, having sent on their way the spent commuters who stream uncertain by. And as for this whole splurge of a city, isn't money at its heart? But I'm blathering now, forgetting my subject. What I meant to say at the start is that I noticed a woman reading in a chair not far from mine. Silver-haired, calm, she stirred a hunger hard for me to define, perhaps because she doesn't seem lonely. And what I loved was this, the way when dusk had darkened her pages. As if expecting a kiss, she closed her eyes and threw her head back, book open on her lap. Perhaps she was thinking about her story, or the fall air, or a nap. I thought she'd leave me then, for pastimes more suited to the dark. But she is on intimate terms, it seems, with the rhythms of Bryant Park, for that's when the floodlights came on, slowly, somewhere far above my knee. And the grass grew green again, and the woman reopened her eyes to read. Now I'll read one more piece, which is three parts, and each part is a sort of a translation or an imitation. I guess I call them imitations rather than translations because I take sort of unconscionable liberties with them. It's called Alteration Finds, and the first section is called Delirium, and it's after a snippet of prose from Rimbaud's Season in Hell, and I've taken the prose and translated it into verse. Delirium. How many hours I kept that vigil by your side, entire nights, eyes wide, as you so sweetly slept. What I was wondering, why you yearned to evade the real. No one has prayed harder for anything. It wasn't for your life, I feared, but for mankind. Did you in the end find secrets for changing life? The second part is called Defaced, and it's after Rilke's sonnet, The Archaic Torso of Apollo, and I have trimmed it down considerably. The head we cannot know, nor its bright fruit, the eyes, and yet the body has its gaze, a lamp turned low. Or else the breast would cease to dazzle, the hips fail to curve into that smile that begets more than a kiss. And flesh would lose all life, not flare, till there's no blind it can't see you behind. You must change your life. Three, Denial. This is after the Greek poet George Sisyphus. The afternoon grew hotter along our secret shore. We thirsted in the glare, but couldn't drink the water. On golden sand, we traced your name beside the sea. The wind came like like a sigh. Our writing is erased. How passionate our life, how full of sex and song, spirit and heart. How wrong, and so we changed our life.
Blood in the dark.